What I like about this effect is that the spectator, they can even hold the ring and the chain, and still they cannot even figure it out. Well, as far as I'm concerned, you know, it is a really nice effect. However, I only do the linking part. I don't do the unlinking because I don't really like that much. I don't think it's that convincing. This is the principle. Then I'm gonna tell you what you need to tell the spectator in order for them to accomplish this effect without even noticing. The chain, this one is about 39 inches long. You can go plus minus 2 inches. And the ring is 2.5 inches in the outside of the diameter. I will explain some variations later. This is the principle, okay? When the ring goes right inside the chain, you have to have the ring flip 180 degrees. When it flips, it makes that little knot right there. It is a self-working effect. The audience can even do that. So when you give the ring to the spectator, you ask the spectator to make a fist, then open the index and thumb. When you place the ring right there, you're gonna ask the spectator to let it go. When they let it go, the ring is gonna hit the middle finger, making the ring flip 180 degrees. That's the secret, and that's how it works, by making the ring flip. But when you put the chain right there, you ask the audience, what do you think is gonna happen if you let go the ring? They will say, well, it's gonna fall. And you say, correct. It is very important that the only movement they're allowed to do is just move the index finger out of the way. Because I came across several times that when the spectator, they let it go, they move the hand out of the way. So that is imperative that you tell the audience, do not move the hand, do not move anything. All you can do is just move the index finger. That's all you can do. And when they do it, at the count of three, it's gonna make the ring flip 180 degrees. That's all. And that's how this is gonna work as well. Now, if it doesn't work, as you just watch, of course it's gonna happen once in a while, but if it doesn't work, then the excuse you can give to the audience is, I need to snap my fingers. That's the second attempt. You're gonna count down to three again, but this time you will snap your fingers, okay? And that's it. Just make sure the ring is about halfway in, about halfway, and then you let go right there, okay? Don't go all the way up. Just halfway is gonna work pretty well. If you wanna get it out, which I don't think that's really amazing because the audience is not gonna be part of it anymore, but just watching it, it goes out the same way it went in. For this, you can use smaller rings, about 1.5 inch. I don't wanna use rings about 1.5 inch in diameter because then you cannot make the audience participate by holding the ring because it's gonna be smaller. But the good part of it is you can get it out faster. So when you do this, that's gonna happen easier and faster when smaller rings, because it goes out the same way it went in, which is pretty much going around the ring, okay? I'm gonna do it once again, really slowly. When you use smaller rings, when you hit it on the ground or in your hand, the ring or the chain goes on the sides, and that's it. If you want, you can do it under the cover of your hand, which is better because you can use your thumb as a helper. Okay, that's the first part. You wanna get it out. When you hit it on the hand, you can hold with a thumb one side of it, one side of the loop, and the other side is gonna fold this way, the left side, and with your thumb you go the opposite side of it. Don't make this performance sideways because they can see the ring spinning. It is better if you do it yourself. You don't want the audience to participate. You do it in front. This is the second grip, the second variation. The middle finger goes right under. I'm exaggerating. You don't need to go this much. So they can see it in the front. Okay. And the way to get it out the same way it went in. But for that, you need smaller rings, about 1.5 inches. But if you use 1.5 inch rings, it's gonna be more difficult to ask the audience to participate. Because when you ask them to hold the ring this way, it's gonna hit the middle finger. When they let it go, you have to make sure they don't move the hand out of the way. So it is imperative that you ask the audience two things. One, do not move the hand. And two, the only movement they can do is the index finger. Just to move the index finger out of the way, right at a count of three. And then you go ahead, one, two, and three. Make sure the ring is halfway into the chain, so it loops right around the chain. They can even hold the chain. The only issue is that that's gonna be too clean. But that's gonna be up to you. It's gonna work either way if they hold the ring, the chain, or both. Make the audience participate. Really easy. I don't think you need practice at all, because even the audience, they can do it.